Hi, Marco Di Stefano here, and welcome to the third video of the Virtual Orchestration series. In this video, I'm going to show you how I set up the expression maps in my orchestral template. If you want to know more information about how this template was set up, you can watch the video number 3. I'm not going into detail about the configuration of Lemur, Vienna Ensemble Pro and Cubase in this video, so refer to the other one if you want to have more information about this. But to start, I'm using my template. So you see, this is the initial view that I have. And now I want to show you something. So, okay, I will put all the strings into the template. And today we are going to work with a Violin one from the Spitfire Chamber String Library, which has a lot of articulation, so it's very nice to show, to demo with that. Before going to the details, I want to show you what I'm going to share with you. So these are all the expression maps which I set up. So first, the Bernard Hellman Toolkit, the London Contemporary Orchestra strings, the Albion 3, Albion 5, the new alternative solo strings, chamber strings, orchestral swarm, symphonic brass, symphonic strings, and symphonic woodwinds. Inside these libraries, you can see that you will have one expression map files per instrument. So let's look at, for example, the woodwinds here, the brass, voila. The way this is done, I'm going to show within the template itself. So first of all, let's activate the chamber strings violins one. So clicking on this button, it makes the library loaded in Vienna Ensemble Pro. And now if we look inside it, so you can see that here I have loaded with the same MIDI channel 6, I've loaded all the articulation of the violins one. So each of them is set to lock to UACC, which is the Spitfire standards to trigger articulation change using the MIDI control change. And you can see that for each specific articulation, there is a specific value here, 10, 8, 18, which is the value of the control change on the program bank 32, which will trigger the articulation change. Now you can see that on my violins one chamber strings, I am sending MIDI data on the channel 6 of this instance, which corresponds to this and this. So whatever I'm playing here, now you are hearing from there. Look at this. Voilà. Okay. Each instrument here has its own expression map loaded. In the case of this specific one, I'm going to show you how it is done. So here it is. As I said, there are a lot of articulation in the speed and the violins one chamber string. And you can see that all the articulations here, so they trigger a specific control change. For example, when I am sending this articulation, there will be the control change on the bank 32 value 1, which refers to this one. And then, for example, when I'm having some tremolo, when I want to have some tremolo, I'm using this expression map, which is sending a control change on the bank 32 value 11, which is, I suppose, there, voila, value 11. So you see, we switch from one to the other. Also, another thing that you see is that on the left, you got a remote number setup. The way these expression maps are working is with program change message for the remote settings, meaning that if you have a remote which is sending program change 19, when this track is selected, it will automatically make the articulation change to this one, which will trigger the control change on contact, which will change the articulation. This is done, in my case, through Lemur, so I'm going to show you how it's working. So now let's suppose I'm going to play and I'm going to switch here to the Articulation tab. So you can see that depending on the tracks which is selected, articulations change. This list of articulation here is exactly the same list that is set up in the expression map. Now I'm going to click on the first one, Wien legato, the long. So. And when playing, I want to go to pizzicato. Pizzicato con sordino. Tremolo. And so on. So you can go also with the legato, whatever you want. So the list that you see here in this window is in exactly the same order of the list which you have seen in the expression map. And each button on Lemur is sending a program change, which is increasing starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The program change is exactly the same of what we see here in the remote. So 1 is the long, the 2 is the long concertino, the 3 is the long harmonics, and so on. And so this is done for all the expression maps, and this is done for the whole Lemur project. So what I'm sharing with you is these are all expression maps which are fully tested. So you can be sure that all of them, each single articulation will trigger the right sound in contact. Another way to I'm using these expression maps is, for example, wait, look at this. Now let's record something. Okay, so let's just record actually. Cool. Let's see here. So you can see that these are recorded and these are all the articulations. So then what you can do is that you can change articulation during the play like that. Okay, that's it. I hope that you will use these expression maps, that it will help to create your orchestral template. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share my videos. And again, thank you for watching and looking forward to the next one.